aviation, seems very glamorous. On the contrary, behind all that glamour is a lot of hard work and turmoil. Now, if you have the right learning attitude, you will not just grow in aviation, but also in life. We, as pilots, especially young budding pilots, invest lakhs and lakhs of rupees for a commercial pilot license. Yet, once you get that license, you still might not know what to expect. Hi, I'm Ravish Bhalla, and I'm working on this to change, and to learn with you what's new in the aviation world. Since this is my first aviation blog, I wanted to give a shout out to my friends for pushing me to do this, especially Shivang Devari for his support. And during this time of lockdown, I thought I'll make the most use of my time. So without wasting any further time, let's get started. Jokes off. So I get this question a lot. Why do pilots get paid so much when autopilot does most of the work? Or is the job of pilot very easy because autopilot is there? I understand this question is very general if you are unaware about the latest automation system. But if you wish to amuse or annoy a pilot, just ask him this question, and I'm sure this would do the trick. So before stepping into if the pilot's job is easy or not, let me tell you why the autopilot was needed in the first place. Back when the planes were invented, it required pilots' undivided attention to fly the plane safely, which meant the pilot had to be on controls at all times. As the technology advanced, planes got bigger, and it got harder for pilots to manage everything, and hence, aviation engineers decided that we had to do something to reduce pilots' workload, and thus the autopilot was born. Fun fact, the first autopilot was built in 1912 by Sperry Corporation. So let's get down to the reasons. Reason number one, long hauls or long sector flights. So if you are having a long sector flight or even a shorter sector which includes 2 to 6 landings per day, you won't want your pilot to keep holding onto the control stick at all times. That's humanly not possible. And that's where the autopilot plays an important role, so that pilots can focus on better flight management rather than just maintaining a routine wings level flight. Reason number two, being a pilot is stressful. Like if I just Google, most stressful. Now if you see, airline pilot is on number three. Why is that?
So basically there are different phases of flight, which include taxi, takeoff, climb, cruise, descent, landing. Now I will be plotting a graph of stress versus flight time. Let's say taxi has X amount of stress. Then takeoff has a higher stress compared to taxi. Then comes climb, slightly lower stress than taxi. Coming down to the cruise, which covers maximum part of the phase of flight where automation exists. After cruise, we have to plan for descent, and then the stress level starts to increase again, and then finally ends up at landing. So if we just plot this graph, it looks something like this. If you see, the stress level is maximum at the time of landing. Now during landing, takeoff, taxi, you can see the stress level is slightly higher compared to the cruise, and this part is actually performed manually by pilots most of the time. But what happens during the cruise phase, where autopilot is engaged most of the time?
Yes, and this brings me to point number three, troubleshooting and standard operation procedure. In cruise, comparatively stress levels are lower because the pilots have height in hand, thereby increasing their reaction time. However, pilots still constantly monitor aircraft parameters, stay in touch with air traffic controllers, plan their descent, keep an eye out for possible diversion in case of emergency. And if there is weather, they would avoid weather so that you can have your cup of coffee in peace. Reason number four, modern day autopilots are extremely advanced. Autopilot can be engaged 400 to 800 feet post takeoff, and constant input and monitoring has to be given to it. We make that plane auto. At the end of the day, aircraft is a machine that carries lives, and we cannot take this machine for granted. Excessive automation too can be destructive, as we've already seen in the recent past of some fly-by-wire crashes and auto-corrective crashes. Therefore, man behind the machine has to be extremely skillful and at the same time calm and composed. And that's what pilots are getting paid for. You still think it's easy? Think again. So guys, these were my reasons. If you like my video, please give me a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. Because if you subscribe, you'll give me motivation to make such videos. And if you've got any doubts regarding aviation, just comment below. And remember, it's all about attitude. If you learn good, you fly good. See you in the flight deck.